All these heads are gonna roll.
Sometimes they call me Lucifer. Talk about you do this and that. Ain't none of that they're new to us. Acting like that you pop off. No damn well that you grew to us. Been in my own lane. Carry you like that dude the truck. Trend following. I'm surprised you just now catching up. It's my way or the highway, baby girl. I'm not a settler. Don't play with my kind. No matter my mind. I promise you get pitiful. They love me. They love me. I promise I do the bare minimum. My people, they say that I'm underrated. But it's crazy. I'm steady. They killing them. Ride my wave, I'm flipping them. Come up on some earth and I'm dipping them.
I'm so sick of all you. Weak, weak, lame.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas and the very wonderful AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Coming up, we got a good matchup on tap here, as it'll be the Miami Dolphins taking on the Dallas Cowboys. Set for football now at AT&T Stadium. Brandon Aubrey has the honors, and we are underway here in Arlington. Braxton Berrios selected to bring it out. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. A man who is both a prep and collegiate star here in the Lone Star State, Devon Achane. And able to get it across. across the 20 before they get to him. A good start. One play, 10 yards. On first down, Tagovailoa. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. And despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. Now Tua. That's caught by the Notre Dame man. It's Durham Smythe. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll run right side with Mostert. And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. It'll be second down.
They suspected that it was a power play up the middle coming at them. And boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
And they get it behind the line. So that short gain on first down quickly negated. Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. Complete this one to Berrios. And he's going to come up a few yards short. Brought down at the 45. Now before they run this fourth down play, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. Just their first in this half. We'll step aside and come right back. Oh, a big decision here early. Look at this. They're going to go for it on their own side of the field. Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game, and on the opening drive of the afternoon, the defense forces a turnover on downs. And they'll send the tight end in motion here. A first down throw for Prescott. The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Prescott. He's got it at the 15. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. And a pickup of about four down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line. Facing a second and 6 from the 8. Here's Pollard again. That is into the end zone for the Cowboy touchdown. Tony Pollard, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys are on the board first here this afternoon. Now Mike McCarthy going to decide to go for two here. Prescott, they're going to throw for it. It's caught. And it's 8-0. And around the goal line, especially on two-point tries, sometimes the QB's best friend is a big target, the tight end.
I love how you described it, because you know he's going to have some length and some catch radius, as well as a big body to keep people away from the football.
So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. Berrios going to bring this out of the end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive.
Charles, we know that this offense is aggressive. We saw that last drive they went.
And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 39 yards there, a big one.
As always, no rooting interest here, but that was pretty, wasn't it, to see him break through and then pick up his stride.
Yeah, the guy carrying the ball loves it. I think the O-line, they might like and take more satisfaction out of those runs than anybody else, right?
Without a doubt, because they're the ones that often have created it.
That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. A run with Mostert up the middle. And down to the 36-yard line here. A nice job there as he rumbles for 9. And it'll be back to a 33. They'll run for it with Achane. And he'll be taken down, as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. One quarter down, 8-0 the score. It's Dolphins football here as we begin the second quarter, as they've got it with a first and 10. Up the middle they go with Mostert. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. And tip your cap to DeMarcus Lawrence. Nice play defensively. That loss of 3, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13.
To his throw, caught by his receiver, Hill.
Touchdown! Tyreek Hill, 29 yards. And the Dolphins have cut the lead back down to 2.
As they began this last drive, things weren't exactly looking up for this offense. But after what they just did, putting the ball in the end zone, that took them away from the brink of possibly being knocked out of this game.
Tua and the Dolphins' offense staying put. They'll go for 2. It's a run with Mostert. And he'll get him to tie this game at 8. Well, it's definitely early enough here. They didn't need to go for 2. They didn't have to go for 2, but hey, they did. We're all tied at 8.
Is this one of those anything you can do, I can match? Yeah. Because that's exactly what we got on that one. Neither one of these teams wants to give any ground, do they?
So 8-8, our score now, as he'll send this one away. And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown. And the last time out looking to repeat that, Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
A Cowboy first down there, Prescott to Gallup.
I like watching the wide receiver screen, because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? Guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Give them 18 on that one, and it's a Dallas first down.
That's good for our Cowboys. First and 10 at the 34-yard line.
Pollard going to try the right side. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Second and a couple. Going to run again here with Pollard. And he's able to motor his way down to the 16-yard line. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy first down. We often give credit to the O-line there. 2 tight end formation. Those tight ends block pretty well also.
Yeah, that's one of the most dynamic positions in football now. The tight ends who can block at the line of scrimmage at the point of attack, and they can also get downfield and catch the football.
So the completion good for 6 yards, and it'll be second down. They run straight ahead here with Pollard. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. Just a yard of the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a 3rd and 3. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Trying to run forward, Pollard. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up 4th down. The Dolphins going to take their 2nd timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number 1.
Make them work for it.
And the move from Mike McCarthy is going to be to keep the offense on the field here on 4th down. They're going for it.
Right now.
Let's go.
throwing. Prescott. And a quick throw here. That's complete. Touchdown, Cowboys. Brandon Cooks. As the first half is winding down. And the Cowboys have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Try an onside kick. And the Dolphins are going to recover. A second quarter onside kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had the right situation, you know, and the right approach in going after it. Also may signal that they feel like they have the superior team, that they can try these sorts of things and it won't come back and hurt them later.
Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Tua once again here on second and 10. And going deep for Hill. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked up by Marquise Bell. And the Cowboys are going to have it here at their own 9-yard line. That throw, Charles, over the middle of the field, and a few too many bodies in there got picked.
That's a normal situation, too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field sometimes, there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw, or maybe the ball's tipped, or just too many bodies in the area, an interception can result.
And he will step out of bounds here inside the 30. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. And they've got it. They recovered it. But hang on now, though. There's a penalty flag down.
Well, CD, you understand. I mean, they're so eager trying to get back in this game here the fourth quarter, but they touched that one a little too early before it went 10 yards.
Brandon, in such a high-stakes scenario, everyone's feeling the pressure on this play. Special teams coordinator, which one is he going to pick in terms of kicks? Can the kicker execute it? Can the team wait for 10 yards? So many variables, and in this case, they didn't get it done.
Here now, second and 9 from the 39-yard line. They'll run left with Pollard. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 54 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had it and dropped it. That is an unforced error there, and it takes away what could have been a touchdown.
Oh, I don't know if he's sensing contact to come or what, but that's a ball he'd love to have back. That could have gone for big yardage, but it just didn't want to stay in his hands. That's a tough break.
Now Prescott. With his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cowboys have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Now Mike McCarthy saying, let's go for 2. They'll try and throw for it. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up 2 more. So they go with a pass there on the 2-point try, and they can go to Charles.
And a good job by the offense figuring out their 2-point play and using it well. It's interesting how people are using the strategy nowadays, though, isn't it?
It really is, and I don't know how much that one, that particular play, factored in, but with the PAT moving back in 15-16, that kind of changed things, didn't it?
It's really a part of everyone's strategy now. When I talk with coaches and when we sit with them, they always talk about they actually have 2-point periods in practice now, something they never really did before.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, and some guys, you know, they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes and get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, the goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit, in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Well, the pressure gets there, and Tua's going to be taken down. It'll be a loss of 10, and it'll bring out second. Running the counter with Mostert, and they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. Just a one-yard loss that time, but that's not what they needed. Now they're dealing with a third and long. Tua going to throw. And going deep for Hill. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Two things you can do in that situation. Run and punt the football and try to take your shot at getting the first down. They chose the latter, but I have to punt all the same.
They found once in this spot earlier, but the offense will stay out to go for it on fourth down. They're going for it. Here's Tua with it. And they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. What a real head scratcher there. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. Prescott on first down. Well, that one drops down. Incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down. To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're in the second half. That's just his second incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
Meanwhile, this one knocked down in the backfield. It's incomplete.
Well, they approach this drive with a lot of confidence after their last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on their first two throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on third down
to get the momentum going again.
And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash, dropped at the one. Now with the play clock down to two, we're going to get a timeout here. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Touchdown, Cowboys! Three touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott, and the Cowboys have moved out in front by three touchdowns. So another touchdown there, and even though we're still just here in the third quarter, kind of hard now to see them giving up this lead.
And this is just an offense that's imposing its will right now. You name it, they're able to do it. If you're the play caller, whatever you want to select is there. You want to run it, you want to throw it, pick a play, any play. They're rocking and rolling right now.
So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. Berrios now from his end zone.
Claxton Berrios on the return. The Dolphins take over first and 10.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
And going deep for Hill. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Across midfield, and he will take this all the way down to the 38-yard line.
Well, I guess we're at the point of the game where they do need to open up the playbook a little bit, start to take some chances down the field, but that one did not go as planned.
Yeah, these guys need something good to go their way, and they took an opportunity to take that shot there.
But obviously that's touchdown, Cowboys!
Dak Prescott now four touchdown passes on the afternoon. And the Cowboys get another